exactly 30 minutes past 6 a.m. It's a brand new day, Tuesday, to be very specific. And of course, it is the 5th of February, the month of love. Right here at New Vision, we are doing a very speedy countdown as far as the Harvest Money Expo is concerned. Now, that means we do have only 10 days to go for you to be part of the biggest expo that is going to change your life. Remember, this year's theme is nothing rather than farming is a business. That means you can actually rip big from farming. For those of you who are thinking about quitting your jobs or even looking into retirement, well, farming could be another thing that you could actually think about as far as, you know, retirement is concerned. But anyway, it is a brand new day. Like I did mention, a couple of new energy levels here and there. Now, some of you did have a bad day yesterday, but I can assure you that today is going to be a better day for those of you who are always having good days, just like me every morning. Yes, it's very simple. Now, our social media is going to be open. It is actually open. You can get in touch with us right there. For those of you who want to send you a good morning shout-out, hey, get there and, of course, tag those peeps and tell them to watch Aben today, because we do have a live, interesting show for those of you who are interested in this one. I have a crew with me, as usual, Tina Fierce and Willis Daly joining me on this one. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Derek.
How are you guys doing?
It's a cup of tea. It's a cup of tea in the morning. Yeah, it's a cup of water. That's a cup of nonsense, but it's all right.
Sip some nonsense.
Yeah. But anyway, guys, good morning. Good morning. It's a Tuesday, and I have to keep psyching myself up. Ever get into, like, I keep telling people, Monday is not the problem. Tuesday is when you feel like it's not really easy, long week. Good Lord.
I usually like to say good morning to people who are out of Kampala, if you know, in Adjumani, Gulu, Arua, you know, West Nile, basically, Pakwach. It's a bit, you know, it's a dry season, it's very hot, so that morning is has some sort of mist, the air is sort of warm, so you're not sure if it's cold or what, but Kugama, you maneuver through. So people of West Nile, Pakwach, Arua,
and the grass
Gulu
has a lot of dew.
I don't even interface with the grass like Kampala. There's dew like in my compound. I've never noticed there's that much dew because
it's Kampala. You have a lot of toxins, you have a lot of the model cars.
There's air pollution, there's sand.
Oh, wait, you people are talking about your respective villages.
No, I'm talking about respective villages. Good morning to people in West Nile. That's not my village. From his village.
That's why I'm saying I have not seen dew in a very long time, because it's nowhere nearby my neighborhood. You get?
You can come to mine. Yeah, I'll give you time to just look at the grass.
Do you have grass? Dew?
I have dew in my grass.
Oh, you have grass in your dew. Yes, Kampala, we are here now. Of course, we're getting this show on the road with some shout-outs coming through. Now, mine are going all the way to South Sudan. Yeah, these guys have actually shocked everyone. Now, apparently, the government of South Sudan has come out to, you know, try one of their army generals in prison. Now, this is, of course, coming in after he failed to some orders. A story right here says that a military court on Monday began hearing the trial of an army general charged with treason for allegedly plotting a rebellion against President Salva Kiir's government. Now, apparently, Major General Stephen Boy has been charged with treason offenses related to insecurity as well as disobeying military orders, according to the army deputy spokesperson, Brigadier General Santo Dominic. He's being tried by a 7-member military court panel constituted by the Chief General Jock Riak. Hey, now, this is going down in South Sudan. We'll wait and see how this one gets to unfold. But, of course, at the end of the day, it's not good to, you know, disobey orders, especially if you're an army officer. So he's probably going to be put to the books of law. And who knows? He could be tried and maybe even given life imprisonment or even put on a suicide kind of mission, because treason is something that is not a joke in different countries. That's my shout-out coming in from South Sudan. And, yeah. How do they say good morning in South Sudanese?
I'll ask the other Sudanese guy.
Well, I don't know.
The other guy was your buddy. What was his name? The rich son from South Sudan.
The one who says he got his money from God.
From God.
His name?
Who?
The guy was showing us
Malong.
That one.
Malong Junior Mabio.
Malong.
Malong Junior.
But you see. What's in your WhatsApp message?
Talk to him.
Well, you need to understand one thing. What is treason? You understand? What is treason? In Africa, when you disagree.
At this rate, I feel like I have treason already. Just the fact that I have refused.
You can't have treason. It is not a cap.
It is what?
You commit treason.
You commit treason.
I think I have committed.
You can't have it. It's not a point.
I have treason. You mean my country have treason? You cannot have treason.
It is a very, very long morning. I'd also like to send my shout outs to the Uganda Cancer Institute. Now, of course, I know, remember, you got the letter on Sunday. There was Zumba. There was different things. And yesterday actually happened to be the World Cancer Day. Now, in light of that, this is what they did, and I'm so excited. So, Uganda Cancer Institute has managed to get their third radiotherapy machine. Now, remember how the first one gave us all so many problems? Guess what? This time they got the third one, and of course they're saying the machine will be here by March. It was announced by Mrs. Joyce Mariku Kaduchi and then the State Minister for Health in a press release regarding the commemorating of this year's World Cancer Day. And in addition to the second radiotherapy machine that was acquired, guess what? We have a third one. I think it's a good bold step because we all opened our eyes to cancer after the only time, and this is so sad, the only time we take these diseases seriously is when they affect people who are in the know. I all remember when the late Rosemary Nankabirwa was going through her battle, her fight. That is when we all, you know, open our eyes to it. So I feel like it's a good stride for them and for government and for our health sector.
It's a good initiative.
Radiotherapy. Of course, it's not the most. We'd expect every government hospital to have its own radiotherapy machine, but at least three is good to go.
My only problem comes in with servicing these machines. They bring them, but they don't take an initiative upon themselves to actually teach Ugandans. Not even servicing Ugandans. The last time the machine did break down, we didn't have anyone responsible or who can even have this close an idea of what is going on with the machine. They had to wait for the operators to come in and fix the machine. So I believe that if these guys give us the machines, let them teach these Ugandans.
It all goes down to the different schools we have, especially the medical schools. If you do not have lessons for people who are supposed to be in the technical part of medicine, you can't expect to have such machinery and run it.
I think that we...
Because, I mean, radiology is not something simple. How many radiologists do you think we have?
We have a few.
Yeah, very few.
Our problem as Uganda in the health sector is not having machines and equipment. That's not our problem. Well, that's the bigger picture. That's the long-term project that we should be investing in. But right now, government should be thinking about the human resources that we have in that sector. I think that instead of spending billions of shillings to buy a machine now, we should be spending billions of shillings to take out students to study radiotherapy and about cancers. We need to get researchers, and we need to have all sorts of these people who are educated that are Ugandan and bring them home to deal with the disease. Those people will come up with knowledge and will make recommendations. You won't be surprised that their recommendations may not include getting a machine now.
This is something that was really, really needed. Because you understand, if you do not have a radiotherapy machine, then it's pretty much doom is you.
The problem is having a radiotherapy machine that breaks down and you need to take it to Kenya, to Nairobi.
That's exactly my point.
Guys, can we, for a minute, I do understand where you're coming from, I do understand where you're coming from, but it's a good step. Have you been to the cancer ward in Malawi?
I have been there.
And when someone tells you we have been seated in line
for 4 to 5 days just waiting for my patient to get into the radiotherapy machine. And then you ask, what's the problem? They're like, we're overbooked, Tazimala. So that's where I'm coming from. I'm like, you know what?
But you see, where you're coming from is a wrong move.
I do now. You cannot always be the objective one. You're becoming like those power people.
No, you're the one who is making the decision.
I think what Gina is trying to say here is that we should actually appreciate.
Stop these things of attempting Kenya. Educate for now.
Can we as Ugandans stop making decisions emotionally? You understand?
So it's that's like an emotional decision for them.
No. What I'm saying is that let's not come from a point of view of we have long lines of cancer patients. Let's have sustainable and make decisions that will last 15 to 20 years.
And if we imported
a machine and in 2 months it broke down. You understand? Those are the problems that we need to be solving as Ugandans. If we bring a machine, who is going to operate it? Do we have people that, you know, we've put money in people to do it?
On that note, I'd like to shout out to a guy in Adjumani. He's an environmentalist who says his life is in danger, and that is because he tried to fight a business lady there who was cutting down trees in a forest 40 kilometers from Adjumani town. This guy is saying, me, I will fight for the environment, but this lady here comes through to cut down very indigenous trees, and we won't be allowing it.
Tumunonye fena tumukubo mukazo yo erinya ye yani
Ned Gasebo wachishwa kuita kwacha mateka mungalo bangatwa ya mungalo
siku tabi ya mungalo
abantu babo metanda
kwa mungu justice
kuno kuba kuwe mukira
but you remember. Why are you even trying? Why is he trying to say that it's okay? Remember when you had?
I know it's okay.
Remember when we had the first time we had it that they had sold Mabira? That just made me freeze.
Me, I remember like, when I was a young kid. There's like a picnic area in Mabira, and whenever you pass through Mabira, monkeys would come
and play and eat.
Actually, for my dad used to tell me that monkeys would come and jump on the cars. In my time, they would not jump on the cars because there were lesser trees. They would just stay on the roadside and you'd throw bananas at them.
Now imagine
there's no monkey in Mabira Forest
whatsoever.
So ebintu bino tuleke genda musimanya ko
atumukume
oli musage nga asalo omuti mukola wi
alaba bazuya nanga bali nakati
awe nyini but I think that
kuloga ko oli jakubo omuti oli my friend
abaji tema tebasola kola tebasola kuloga. These are very hungry people
and what's sad omanye omuti bona agutema no gubajamu, let's say a piece of, you know, furniture like this, I understand, like it's sustenance. It's going to be there for a while, right? Now you have these idiots. Bajitema kuocha mumanda.
And the trees. Tuna briquettes.
We don't need.
Deforestation is wrong.
The trees that are being cut actually are trees that trees that are hard to. They are species that are hard
to
grow. These are trees that take over 100 years to grow, 80 years to grow. So if someone is not planting the trees and someone is cutting them for logging, you know, cutting them up and then exporting them.
We should literally start encouraging reforestation, in other words.
Yes.
We should encourage people to grow trees, but also this kind of lumpens like this to cut
by beating them.
So we need to stand behind.
But is beating them a solution?
Yes, we need to stand behind Mr. I've forgotten his name. We need to stand behind people like him who are environmentalists, are coming out to shout and say, people, we need these trees.
I was in Mabira. We went. We passed through the Griffin Park side, and we were talking to the tour.
William Amanzu.
We were talking to the tour guide, and we were like, "There's like there's a part of this forest that we cannot let you go to. Dead in the center of the forest is where they have all the indigenous species, all the species for all the trees that we have within Uganda. That is like their bank. Now, bosango muntunga chano nyerezanga tena injiri. They have not yet really. They're still young.
My dad told me once, there's a tree in our home. It's been there for like, I think, 150 or 60 years old. He said, if you cut this tree, you'll have to first cut me.
Wow.
I want to meet his daddy.
Talking about trees, there are some of the reasons as to why we do have different weather changes in the country. Now, here is our weather forecaster from different parts of the country.
We'll be right back.
Well, there you have it for your weather forecast this morning. Of course, taking you across different parts of the country. Moving away from that, we want to get straight into our last night online. Now, we pick a tweet from a one and only Pepper Faisal on Twitter. Hey, Tina, could you please read out that tweet?
Meanwhile, my boy has been with his girl for 2 years. They went for Kuchala yesterday, and the dad told them he can't allow her daughter to marry someone who isn't Munyankore, and most especially a Muganda. Now, 2 freaking years, he says, supporting the girl, and now this.
The father said no.
The father said no. He is the father of the bride. Hey. But
you who told you to take care of him?
Why are you just today? No, but you see, growing up. Now I know because I saw how the conversation spiraled out of control from just mere compatibility. It went down to tribalism. It went down to so many things, right? But my question is. To that girl. Ogenda fumbane tatao.
But you need your dad's blessings.
You do need the blessing.
Yes.
But when all is said and done, your father has lived his life. He's loved who he has loved. He's had you. He's fulfilled enough to actually have right over you. What about you?
You misunderstand having right over someone.
Our parents lately, when it comes to marriages, I always used to find it weird. It's customary, you know. It's really it's tribe. Like different tribes have different things, right? So like you go to this tribe, they're like, for us, our daughter, you take for 7 goats. For us, our daughter, and koko satu. Nowadays, a father will stand and he's like, "Wangu tabacha mkuwali da koko na mbuzi. Wangu agenda kubiba anja." Range Rover. So for me, in a way, I'm like, bride price is already a bad thing for me. For me.
I think it all goes back
you guys,
to...
You guys misunderstand bride price.
Families we have been the raised different in families. And no. The kind of parents that we do want. At the end of the day, they are the ones to decide whether they want bride price or not. I may not believe
no,
in it.
Okay, let's
you know, my girlfriend may not believe in it, but doesn't mean that
if that's
you know,
what they want,
when the father tells me that, you know...
It's culture.
It doesn't mean that I don't have to look for them. If I really want to marry the girl, I will. I mean, it's culture.
Okay,
it's
now this guy wants to really marry the girl. They're saying no because he's not
you see,
tribe.
Yes. Now, Almighty, you know what they say? They fear what they don't know. And they what?
They hate what they fear.
They hate what they fear. The other one is that if an African does not understand anything, it is witchcraft. In this case, when Ugandans don't understand the difference in genes and families,
genealogy,
they
and
say
that.
You're being tribalistic. That parent is not being tribalistic. Being tribalistic is me saying Ndi Musoga, Derek Munyankole, I am better. That is being tribalistic. But for me to say that I cannot sit on the same table with Derek for these certain hours because of he will be time. Like this and this, and that stems from this and this and this. That's not being tribalistic. That is me being logical.
Willis.
Let me explain to you something.
Willis,
we come from listen. When a man and
when
a man and a woman have a child, two genes have come together. What are genes? Genes are, they are sort of, they come with habits, genes come with colors, genes come with all sorts of things.
Traits.
So genes come with traits. So different tribes have different genes. So they have different lines. That's why you can be a Musoga, you can be a Muganda, you can be a Munyankole. Those are families, and families build into societies. So when a parent comes up and says, you know what, from those ends, value but never but never but. So, fe ngafe, jebaja tukwela mu family yafe. You ought to think about it as a child and respect your parent enough to put it into consideration.
Well,
you may choose to have a big head and go on.
Here are two things I make out of this whole kind of situation. First and foremost, I believe, because you've just given us your personal opinion why I believe this is not tribalistic. Personally, I believe this is tribalistic because the father went ahead to say that you are not a Munyankole, more so I cannot let my daughter marry a Muganda. You see, he's being very specific.
Because
he has thrown about different tribes. From my perspective, I feel like this is being tribalistic. That is one. Two, on the other hand, I blame the woman or the girl, you know. If you've been in a relationship with someone for two years, it's up to you to know that, you know what, at the end of the day, my dad is not going to accept this guy because he's a Muganda. Mm. You get it? Mm. So sit down the guy and tell him, man.
It's like this.
It's like this. You get it? My dad is not going to accept you because of A, B, C, D. Mm. And let this guy decide. I mean, if
that's how you choose,
you have to choose because you're too much.
I choose your medicine
with the consent. You get. So you decide if you want to break up and you feel like that's the best solution, then you do break up.
But if you want to play that Titanic thing of let's go to Canada and disappear,
you want to unlock and stuff.
If you have the money, why not?
Guys, listen. Now this is me. Y'all are coming from logic, from being radical. I think I'm just going to come from being Tina.
I thought experience.
Yeah,
I'm just saying.
Oh well, there's that too. I have some fish on my resume. Uh-huh. That
you can't continue.
Mm. The thing here that I want to know, first of all, I feel that girl was dumb and stupid at the same time. Because if you have grown up in a particular family, you know certain things. Growing up, I'm a Munyoro, right? Growing up, it was always unheard of for us to, for any of my aunties to bring like a Muganda man.
Mm-hmm.
Like it was known. You cannot just bring a Muganda man. We actually, growing up, I only had two Muganda uncles, you know? Mm-hmm. And even they were not necessarily in the loop with the family. And it went on and stretched for a very long time, right?
Mm.
Until one day, one of my aunties actually had another person she wanted to marry, and he was in Muganda, and they brought up the same conversation of like, Omani, baliwebati, and I remember what she said. She said, Grandpa, Grandma, y'all met each other, y'all are happy, y'all are from wherever you're from, they happen to come from the same tribe.
Yeah.
But the world is evolving.
Mm.
It's a global market. It's a global village. I will find who I know will treat me right.
Mm.
You know? If you find the one and they are going to treat you right, I do not think there is no way you can't sit down with these people and say, he may come from a certain place.
Mm-mm.
But that place he comes from is what has buffered him into this beauty that you see in me.
Mm-mm.
That is why I'm confident. Enough to bring him to you, because I know she knows that the dad was going to say something like that.
Willis, in
general, my dad used to say when we were growing up, he said that, you know, there's this idea of someone coming and telling you as kids, and they say, I don't like your dad, and then they pretend to like you. My dad used to say, if someone doesn't like your father, chances are probably 100% that they don't like you too.
Of course.
So,
of course.
And some parents have been through a lot, all through the life journeys of a father. They've seen a lot.
They want the best for their daughters.
So for a daughter like that, you've known someone for just 2 years, and your father says, I had to molest her because of this and this. I think you need to sit down with your dad and be
exactly.
Like,
what's up?
What happened? Good. You understand? You never know that probably along his life, he met a Muganda who disappointed him.
I think the only person that can fix this relationship is
just
the girl.
No, listen to how I finish it.
It's the girl.
Chances are that if someone disappointing him as a Muganda, they are going
bias.
To disappoint you.
So this is not even
child.
Tribal.
Because
this is bias.
It's not tribalism.
It has
bias.
A lot of history.
Only this.
Bias.
It has a lot of history. Mm. If someone has disappointed you as Derek, chances are that a person from similar lineage can disappoint your child. Because
True.
You share genes.
True.
You understand? Your brains are alike. You think alike. Your blood groups are probably the same.
So you say with your fellow Basoga, you're different.
Aren't you worried that Kugambia chances?
I have met him with his kinsmen.
Let me break it down for you. Genes. If Mze Willis, you understand? I have genes, I have a way I think, I have a way I talk, I have
True.
A way I relate to people.
True.
I have my sort of intuitions and spiritual things around me.
True.
Something can happen. So if Munyankole babe disappoints me, you understand, and hurts me, and we don't relate. At the beginning of life, probably I'm 25. And then I go on in life and have a daughter. Chances are, if you meet
you're going to tell your daughter.
No, I won't tell her, but if chances are that if she meets a Munyankole, ngasimuoze mukali,
Ngakong, chances are that their genes won't connect. That is why incest is illegal.
It's a lie. At that point in time, we are not going to agree.
That is a bias. You cannot begin putting that on genes.
I may not just know how to put it.
Let me tell you something. So my heart has been broken by like 5 different tribes, right? When I meet them, I don't have to know.
I'm not saying chances are that your daughter...
Exactly. But there is no way. Because as much as there have been bad people who have broken my heart from there, when I meet other people from there, I'm like,
from the same problem.
And then so I'm not going to begin. That is spreading hate. That is spreading hate. When my daughter come up and she tell me, mom, I think I've met a Musoga.
Let me take it away from that. Let me put it into Chinese.
Listen.
That is bull crap now. That is bull crap. You are now trying to do that issue.
Chena and Willis. Chena, I am going to show you my life this many times.
No,
anyway, like I was saying, Ivan today is going to give you another reason as why you need to look out for the newspapers this morning. You do need to keep yourself acquainted with what is happening within and outside the country in our press digest. A quick look at the new vision, still going for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings. They say government has no money for local council one bicycles. A detailed story is on page 6. It's not funny, guys, but there's actually no money.
Let's catch up with that story.
Government wants to scrap PLE. That is, of course, the primary living examination. Why?
Okay. I'm sorry, I'm still stuck with the bicycles.
All right. Page 5 gives you detailed information right there. Harvest Money Export sponsors vow to showcase the best. Now you get to catch up with the story of, our CEO meeting with some of those sponsors and get to find out what people to expect. Nara introduces high-quality Danish dairy cows. These ones will be giving us milk, so get to catch up with that story as well. We do bring you some news regarding the PLE story and why government is considering to scrap it off. Being a Tuesday, we take you to the oil and gas industry. We do have the oil and gas journal that is out every Tuesday to keep you informed with what is happening as far as your gas and oil is concerned. Now, we do have some international news, of course, and a couple of others right here in today's copy over the new vision, not forgetting some sports at only 2,000 Ugandan shillings.
And of course, a quick look at Bookend. Don't forget, we're still celebrating 25 years of press excellence here. And yes, the Harvest Money Expo is still on from the 15th down to the 17th. Come, let's make money, let's grow money. And in Bookend, they are saying, police and yesterday, very scary story. I don't know if you guys read about it, of the guy who abducted the girl and killed her. Now, it turns out he was actually one of them. He was a serial killer, and they're saying his wife came out and said, now, there's a very, very sad story here. Omwana ba musse ku somero on the first day of school. Omulambo ba gweba siza mu bana ba dekea okubuza obujulizi. Now this is like, this is a very young, beautiful soul. I just don't like to see this. It makes me want to call school my kids. I know. And then Senga Gambie, ebintu abagala nabye basirikira. And of course,
No,
my dear, bad birth is something that we shall not be a part of.
The Daily Monitor is an interesting paper for you. And if you look at the front page, if you bought yourself a copy already, you'll see there that there's a auto sitting at the back of a pickup. There's a police officer there, and they're saying police arrest actually MPs.
What was the deal?
They attempted to demonstrate in Guru town yesterday. The MPs were protesting against the recent attacks on a Choli community in two villages in Apache district.
who told all opposition and anyone who wants to send a message that the best way to send a message is by striking?
You know.
That is what we are calling genes.
The Daily Monitor is also running the story, Ugandan children are not learning, and that is something from the World Bank. Hospital pays 10 million to end 5-year suit by baby.
Wow.
Hey, it's a very interesting story there. Meanwhile, there's a story here about the World Bank report, and I saw a statement that the Minister of Education said that this is because of the instability in the 1980s. City Shua, but get yourself a copy of the Daily Monitor.
She blamed it on something, that
hey!
Do we have...
Nawangwe open stocks with Mark suspended staff. If your father is one of the lecturers who are suspended, he's probably going to be in talks with Nawangwe. I won't go much into the Daily Monitor, but if you go to the 44th page, you're talking about Express and Chisara. Is a dead man walking. Hey.
Yeah.
If you also heard in the international press, The Guardian has a story about Somalia. Apparently there was a suicide bomb, and it was a car bomb that killed at least 11, and a port manager also shot dead. Very sad.
Sad indeed.
There you have it for some of the news to actually look out for as you do get to brighten up your day. Moving away from that, we do go in for a very short break, but when we get back, we'll jump straight into Tea at 7.